everyone. This June 19th, 2020, the day that we celebrate Robbie and Bethany's wedding. We are here because we love Robbie and Bethany. We rejoice that they have found each other and that through each other they have come to know the power of love. We are gathered here today to support and share that love. We celebrate this union of their hearts, minds, bodies, and souls, and we wish them great joy. What is marriage? It is the most important thing that can happen to people in love. A marriage is more than just a husband and wife. It is a bridge which allows the love of two special people to give meaning and worth and wonder to life. There's a continuous process of building, of shaping, of communicating, and of caring. It's the deepest and sweetest understanding. It's sharing today's and tomorrow's together and making each one more treasured and more complete than anyone could ever do alone. A marriage is a home interwoven with hopes and memories and dreams. The thankfulness and love it can bring have no comparison. As family and friends, we are here to form a community of support that surrounds Robbie and Bethany. Each one of you, by your presence here today, is being called upon to help them, to honor them and love each other. Always stand beside them, never between them. Offer them your love and support, not your judgment. Encourage them with your kindness and loving hearts, and honor this marriage into which you have come to be joined today. And now, the Art of Marriage will be read by the maid of honor and sister.
The Art of Marriage by Wilford A. Peterson. A good marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, the little things are the big things. It is never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you, at least once each day. It is never going to sleep angry. It is having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. It is forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each can grow. It is finding room for the things of the spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner.
And now the convocation. Treat your marriage as a living thing. Treat it with respect and nourish it with whatever it needs to keep it young and vibrant. Remember to be kind to one another. Strive to be gentle with criticism and generous with praise. Be empathetic and trusting. Allow yourself to transcend your own limitations through the love that you have for each other. Allow yourselves that love which shatters all limitations and dissolves all fears. What has brought you together will keep you whole, for love is life's greatest emotion and its finest work. May you bless this marriage. May you have many joys and be the light of each other's days. May all that you are and always be in love, and all that is love always be in you. May you always see and encourage the best in one another. May the challenges that life brings your way make your marriage grow stronger, and may you always be each other's best friend and greatest love. Bethany takes all this stuff out, even the sermon that I'm doing. This ceremony is an opportunity for Robbie and Bethany to celebrate their love and to honor everyone who has given so much to them. As their witnesses, you have the privilege of experiencing their love in its highest form, marriage. Love is the strongest power there is. Love can change lives and make the world a better place. Marriage and family are the most significant bonds in our lives. A lasting marriage should continually grow in understanding and respect. Consideration of each other's feelings and needs grow out of truly caring for the other. Because of this caring, it's possible to share the joys and successes as well as sorrows and failures. A good and balanced union is the one that is equal in strength and fragility, which is born and reborn over the years. And I would just like to add a little thing. I've known Bethany. We've worked together for 13 years. When she started, she was just a teenager. I've seen her grow into the most strong, self-sufficient, powerful, intelligent, independent woman, and I knew she would never settle for second best. And when I asked her about Robbie, and if he would call me and talk to me, she said he's a little shy. But she told me the story that one day, a couple Fridays ago, when it was a long day, and Robbie worked all day, and then Bethany took out the boys on a picnic, packed a little picnic dinner for them, and took them to the park. Robbie met her after work, and after working all day, he saw that picnic and he said, "Oh, what's to eat?" And Bethany said, "Nothing. I didn't know you were coming." So Robbie went and played with the boys all night, went home, tucked the kids all in, and not until after that family was tucked in bed did he get himself something to eat. That's a story as simple as it is that says Bethany waited for the right guy. Now, Now we will do the vows, the expression of intent. Robbie and Bethany, do you come to this union with a sincere desire to join your lives together? Bethany, repeat after me. I, Bethany, take you, Robbie, to be my wedded husband, my partner in life, and my one true love. I will cherish your friendship and love you today, tomorrow, and forever. I will trust and honor you and faithfully love you throughout the best and the most challenging times. I will always be there for you, as I have given you my hand to hold. I give you my life to keep. Robbie, I, Robbie, take you, Bethany, to be my wedded wife.
In life.
And my one true love. To have and to hold. From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For richer or for poorer. In sickness and in health, to love, honor, and cherish
all the days of my life.
Having this kind of love in your hearts for one another, you have chosen to exchange rings as a sign and seal of the promises you are making to one another today. From the earliest times, the circle has been a symbol of completeness, a symbol of committed love. An unbroken and never-ending circle symbolizes a commitment of love that is always, also never ending. As often as either of you look at this symbol, you will be reminded of your commitment to love each other, which you have made today. And the rings?
Ring mainly.
I, Bethany, give you, Robbie, this ring, as a symbol of my commitment to love, honor, and respect you. Just as this circle is without end, my commitment to you is eternal. I, Robbie, give you, Bethany, this ring as a symbol of my commitment. To love, honor, and respect you. Just as this circle is without end.
My commitment to you is eternal.
Okay. And now, Bentley, Cam, and Weston. You are a vital part of this new marriage. Mommy and Robbie give you their unconditional love and honor your presence in their lives. You will have a share in this union, for your lives will be touched by the covenant being made here today. Your participation is requested to help develop the bonds of this new family. As Mommy and Robbie have exchanged their pledge in holy union, we ask from you also a pledge that you will join together to weave a fabric of mutual help and comfort, challenge and support and that you will help create a home and a way of life in which all of you grow into the fullness of the best people you can be. As you hold your sand, the separate containers of sand represent your lives to this moment. As you now combine your sand together, your lives will also join together as one family. Just as these grains of sand can never be separated and poured again into individual containers, so will your marriage and your family be one. And now that you have stood before me and the keeper of the stars and exchanged these vows and these rings, it gives me great pleasure to present for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Robert Hamby. You may now kiss the bride.
Officially
hand bone. Ain't another dog bowing around so much.
He is.
He is.